coming into my internship, I didn't have a strong background in paleontology or geology, but a very strong interest in field work and how that research is conducted. And my Smithsonian internship gave me an opportunity to work very closely with one of the researchers here, Dr. Scott Wing, and learn how it is that he conducts his field work and research. It's a long, hard day on the field for sure. You spend all day out in the sun digging, but you're digging thoughtfully, so it's really satisfying, and it's a great blend of physical and mental work. So everything that we do, from choosing where we were going to dig, to the very technique of how it was done, and then examining what you find, because you can't keep every single fossil that you find, involved lots of thought, and it was all things that I went out and had to learn, and did learn, and came back knowing. And in the evening, we would come back to camp, and all these different research teams would meet up. So we had vertebrate paleontologists, paleobotanists, geologists, sedimentologists, geochemists, all out in the field, all studying the Paleo-Eocene thermal maximum, and trying to tell the same story, but from different approaches in their own research disciplines. One of the highlights for me during my internship was one day we were digging, and we found a little bit of a palm frond, and then about a foot away, another portion of it. So a palm frond is one of those big palm leaves. And here we were up in the Badlands where it's dry, there's hardly any water around, and there was this big palm leaf. And we started uncovering more and more of it, and all the ridges were perfectly preserved in the rock. It was really cool to see. And it was a bit like a puzzle where suddenly the pieces were all fitting together because we could find more and more of it. And it was huge. It was incredible to think that this plant had ever been there when now all that's there is this scrubby sagebrush growing. So in the field, you're just collecting and you're trying to figure out what's worth bringing back. And then once you're here, you have to think about what you actually have. And I spent, for example, I spent over a week looking at about 30 different leaves and trying to figure out which ones were most similar to each other, which ones were slightly different from each other. And it sounds like it would be obvious, but if it were, it wouldn't have taken that long. My internship at the Smithsonian taught me what science can mean, that it's not a restricted definition to someone in a white coat in a chemistry lab all day, but that there are all these different fields and research approaches that fall under the broad term of science. So I was very grateful to have had this opportunity and really learned about the extent of what it means to do research and how it functions and what science means. So that was one of the best lessons I learned during my Smithsonian internship.